Welcome back to the channel, and today we continue on with our Power BI series. We're learning how to use DAX, and remember the basic point of DAX is what you want to do is answer business questions. You want to know how much total revenue, you want to know average daily sales, you want to know total number of views in our data model using the YouTube example. But what you're trying to do is think about knowing your data and knowing what different parts of the organization are going to want to know for their data. So today we're going to learn min and max. You can answer a lot of questions just with these two easy DAX functions, min and max. Let's go to Power BI. We're back in Power BI, and again, for those of you just tuning in, we have our data model. And remember, the best case of DAX measures is to try to answer business questions. So to get you up to speed, we have a data model that is a one-to-one relationship. And what this does is we have a calendar table, we have a YouTube fact table, and that YouTube fact table has four types of numbers that we're trying to analyze. It has minutes, revenue, views, and watch hours. And whenever you're looking at a data model, you always want to make sure the relationship that you have, you want to get comfortable with your data. So in our last video, we showed you how to make sum and average. So we currently have three measures: total revenue, total views, average views. Now, as we want to analyze this channel, one of the things we may want to know is what was the most amount of money, the most revenue that this channel made on any one day. So what we can do is make a measure. We go to the table and we go new measure. And this is going to be our max measure. And it's going to be max revenue. And we're going to hit shift enter. And now we're going to type in our function, which is max, and hit tab to pick that up. Now again, for formatting the DAX, we're going to hit shift enter. Now what do we want to see the max of? We want to see the max of the table YouTube and the column revenue. So what we're going to do is total revenue and YouTube revenue. We're going to use YouTube revenue because YouTube is the table and revenue is the column. And now we're going to hit shift enter, hit backspace, and that will format our DAX. You always want to get into formatting your DAX because you have the left parentheses, then you have the right parentheses, that closes it out, and now you can see the max revenue. So this time around, we're going to use a card chart, and a card chart is basically allows you to see numbers in a card format. So this one only asks for one type of data. So the question we're asking here is, what is the maximum number of revenue on any given day for this YouTube channel? So we're going to add the data, and the maximum amount of revenue that it made was $148.66. Now, if we want to see that by month, we can bring it into our matrix and it'll show us the maximum amount of revenue during that month. Because remember, the filter, January 1, 2022, in that month, the maximum amount of revenue was $20.66. And all time, because the only filter context here is all time, it's $148 on any given day. Now we want to see the least amount of revenue. So again, what we're going to do is go new measure, and we're going to format our DAX, which is minimum this time. So we're going to call it minimum revenue. Shift enter, and then we're going to type in min, and that's going to be our function min. And then we're going to hit shift enter for the formatting. Now again, we want to do the revenue column inside the YouTube table. So we're going to type in revenue, and the IntelliSense is going to bring up the YouTube revenue. And then we're going to hit shift enter. We're going to hit backspace, and that is going to format our DAX. So now we have the minimum revenue, and it's located over here in our YouTube fact table as a measure. The measure is that little calculator icon. And now to see the minimum amount of revenue, we are going to bring up another card. And again, the data for this card is minimum revenue. And we're going to drag that to the add data. So the minimum amount of revenue is 65 cents on any given day. The maximum amount of revenue is $148. And these are business questions. Maybe this company, for when they're looking at their YouTube channel, they want to know the most amount of money that it's capable of making, and they want to know the minimum number of revenue. Let's try again a maximum number of views so we can see the maximum number of views on this channel to see how many views they got on any given day. So max views, the equals, shift enter, and now we're going to look for max again. And again, the format for DAX is the name of the measure, then you've got the function, which is max, then we want to determine the table and then the column. Now the table is YouTube and the column is views. So if we type in views, YouTube views comes up. Now in this example, this data model, we have just the fact table YouTube, and then we have the lookup table in calendar. So we're going to hit tab, then we're going to hit shift enter to format, and then we're going to close it out with the right parenthesis, and that'll give us the max views. Now remember, that measure resides in the fact table, and it doesn't actually, it's contextually based. So until we show it in a visualization, we won't actually see that measure. So to see that measure, we need to go to the home table. We're going to add a card, and this card is asking for one type of data, and we're going to bring in the max number of views. And what this is going to show is the maximum number of views on any given day was 33,000. So on one day, this channel had 33,000 views. The most amount of money they made on any given day was $148. The least amount of money was 65 cents. Now we're going to do the minimum number of views, new measure. And again, to format the DAX, the syntax is the name of the measure, minimum views. And you should always give your DAX measure names, names that make sense, so that when you're putting them into your other measures and nesting them into other formulas, you know what you're working with. So minimum views describes it. The syntax is going to be the function, which is minimum. And we're going to select that. Now we're going to format the DAX out by using the table name and the column name. The column name is going to be views, and the table name is YouTube. And now we're going to format that out by closing the parentheses. And now we're going to have the minimum number of views. The minimum number of views, again, is going to be, for another visual, a card visual, we're going to bring in the minimum views. So the minimum number of views was 114 views. The maximum number of views was 33,000 views. But remember, your DAX questions are just trying to answer questions about your data set so that you can start to analyze. And that's all you're really doing with your data model, is analyzing, asking questions, and figuring out how to figure out the answers to those questions. So now later on in this series of videos, we're going to show you how to set up a dashboard. But initially, what you want to do, remember the formula, is set up your data model. Then you want to create your columns and clean up your columns for only the data you need in the data set. Then you want to create your measures. And then the fourth step is setting up your visualizations. So we're still on step number three, which is setting up your measures. And the measures we did this time was min and max. So if you want to watch the first video where we did sum and average, we'll put a link above. And remember, the description contains the data set so you can build the data model as we continue along in our Power BI series.